Hi there. Back at the bench. Some friends of mine came with this PlayStation 4 that they wanted me to take a look at and try to fix. The PlayStation makes some kind of loud noise. It gets very hot and overheats and powers off. So my prediction is a problem with the cooling fan. So yeah, let's take a look. To open the PlayStation, this is the slim version. You have to pull up in each front of the corners on the top lid. Pull back and the cover is off. Very easy. With the cover off, I want to see if I can locate the noise and where the heat comes from. So I will power up the PlayStation. We can see some dents here. So I will call this a plausible Fortnite damage. This is a phenomenon that happens when you play Fortnite for some hours. You get these dents in the metal on the PlayStation. People have tried to figure out how they appear, but until this day, nobody knows. Try to see if the FLIR can find some. This is just a reflection of my lighting. You can see the light still reflects heating. It doesn't seem to be making much noise, but I wonder if that happens when the fan gears up and speeds up, so the fan will interrupt with the dent in the shield. It has run for a while now, but I think you have to game on it to get it to heat up really bad. But my readings are not very high in temperature, but if I use paper card and place it onto the shield, you will see I get a higher reading and more accurate reading because the shield reflects and the card doesn't. So that's a trick if you're measuring with your FLIR on reflective shields. Use a sheet of paper or card or something you have that doesn't reflect. And you see I've got a really hot spot here. So yeah. Let's take it apart, see if we can figure out the problem and fix it or not. So yeah, we got this PS4 with a Fortnite damage. So let's take it apart and see if we can fix it. So we have some shields we have to take off. If I find the proper bit for my WoW stick. Looks like a T8 Torx bit fits. Take off this heat shielding. There are some Phillips screws. A PH1 seems to fit the Phillips screws. On some other versions, there were screws here, 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 and here, and here. But now they have melted some plastic tabs instead. So to take the shield off, I have to cut the tabs off. Just stupid that I don't use screws anymore. Ah, more plastic rivets here. Call it rivets. There. Oh, we have a dust problem that causes the heating. Look at all this dust. So when the fan runs, it just sits and cools itself. So we have to do some cleaning work. Find my garbage can and pair of tweezers. See if we can get this off in a bigger piece. Look at all this dust. Can zoom in. It's no wonder the PlayStation gets hot. Dust piles up over the years. That's just how it is. Look at all this dust. So maybe it's not just a Fortnite problem or Fortnite damage. It's also a dust problem. So after I've removed the dust, I'll straighten the cover back up and assembled it again and try to see if the PlayStation is cooler. Gets cooler. When running. Just inside the vents also. I think I have to vacuum clean the vents. Yep, so I will clean this up and get back to you. Back after some cleaning. Now I can see through the vents. I think this will help a lot. But when I take a look at the shielding, you can see the fan have rubbed against the shielding. So I have to straighten up the shielding again, because I think this have caused the noise problem from the PlayStation. When the fans speeds up and starts to rub against the shielding. It will make some noise. So try to straighten up the shielding again. So the PlayStation is screwed back together. Let's try to power it up and see if the heat problem still is there. So I'll let it run for a while again, then I'll be back. So the PlayStation has run for a while now. I cannot feel the same heat problem that we had before. It was nearly 50 degrees C before. So let's see what it is now. It's the highest measurement is 34. Looks like this fixed the problem, hopefully. Looks like the shielding is sitting quite good without the plastic tabs, because I bent the shielding a bit more down so it sits good. So I will not add any more screws or fastening to the shielding. So it's just to put it back together, slide the cover on and press it down into place. So yeah, hopefully we fixed it. Hope you like my video and subscribe to my channel. Please comment down below if there is something you want to discuss. See you next time.